should not just be concentrating on creating funds for the army and the other civil services without looking at the police. Intelligence gathering in this country is dead. Events will happen, there will be signals that they will happen, and they will happen, and there will be no remedy. Mr. President, before the masses begin to chase us, before they begin to destroy our vehicles and our homes, I think it is time we act and make hay while the sun shines.
I want to start by congratulating Nigerian youths that have been termed lazy, who have proven that Nigerian youths are not lazy, they are intellectually mobile, they are politically sagacious, and they can take their destiny to their hand. So I say kudos to Nigerian youths, I say bravo to the Nigerian youths, and I say this is a breakthrough for all progressives across the length and breadth of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. Keep it up. And the battle to salvage our country from economic cankerworms, from financial scavengers, from police brutality, from ineptitude and impunity is a battle of no retreat, no surrender. This NSAS struggle is a great phenomenon, is a redirection and rebooting of our country, Nigeria. The NSAS is just a starting point. By the grace of God, it will galvanize into a redemption program for the Federal Republic of Nigeria. We need to rebirth our nation. We need to rebuild our nation. And we need to start afresh. And we cannot start afresh when we have indolent people, people who sit in the corridors of their houses and say, I'm not concerned, I'm not perturbed. I personally sat aback because my involvement will be taken advantage of by the federal government and indeed the presidency. If I'd come out early enough, they would have politicized my involvement and see it as an avenue to militarily come on the NSAS movement. So that was why I sat aback, so that this thing can become a proper struggle without political coloration, so that people will know that it is not about political party, it is not about religion, it's not about creed or sex, it's not about what part of this country you come from. It is about the survival of our nation. It is about our togetherness as a people and resistance against evil and ineptitude. I will say that I started the Occupy Nigeria on 2nd of January 2012, and the essence of making this comment on that is because that same day I was arrested and I slept in SARS, and before you know it, the following day I was framed and I was trying to overthrow the government of Goodluck Jonathan by the same SARS. So when you are saying NSARS, I am a victim of police brutality. I am a victim of police torture. As I speak to you, between the police and the Office of the Attorney General of the Federation, I have been arraigned in 12 different courts. Dino Malai versus Federal Government of Nigeria versus IGP, out of which, by the grace of God, I've won 9. So I understand the pains of the Nigerian youth. I understand the pains of the unemployed. And I understand the pains of an innocent young man who is doing well, who is only being accosted on the road because he's properly dressed and being interrogated whether he's a Yahoo boy or not. Success have nothing to do with, not every good-looking Nigerian, not every young Nigerian that is driving a good car is a Yahoo person. In 2018, December to January, in this same house of mine, the police barricaded this place, and you would think that it was Shekau they were looking for. With over 150 policemen inside this house, they shut down water and shut down light, and for 8 days, I did not eat or drink. I was incarcerated inside this house, no light, no water, surrounded by the police, armor tanks brought to the streets. I was maltreated by the Nigerian police. I spent my new year and some days in SARS. I was in SARS for 17 days, locked up by the police. The police fired at me in Kogi. The SARS in Kogi molested me, arrested me, arraigned me, and framed me for murder and for possession, illegal possession of firearm that was planted. The same SARS also arraigned me before a magistrate court in Lokoja, where they brought 2 condemned criminals from the prison and said I was supplying guns to them just to put me in trouble. I went through all this. I am battered. I am broken, but for me, I will continue to speak for the voiceless. I spoke for the police even on the floor of the Senate. I spoke about their welfare. I spoke about improvement. I spoke about my colleagues taking the issue of this killing seriously and doing something before we get to the stage we are now today. So when you are talking about NSAS, no other Nigerian understands your pain, your agony, and what it means to end SARS like Dino Malai. I saw it, I felt it, I went through it. But I want this struggle to be organized. I want this struggle not to be hijacked by hoodlums. I want this struggle not to be politicized. And I will not want anyone to start segregation of saying, this is part of us, this is not part of us. To deliver this country from the hands of ineptitude and irresponsible leadership, we all have a role to play. Many of us, or everyone who has occupied any position in this country, including me, have failed this country. President Muhammadu Buhari has been in government since 1975 in the center. He cannot excuse himself from the state of the nation. I cannot excuse myself from the state of the nation. Anyone who has been a counselor, a local government chairman, a president, governor, cannot excuse themselves from the malady we are in. So, but all we can do is to become born again, have a change of heart, become change agents, and build a nation where peace and justice shall reign. Therefore, all Nigerians must therefore decide to either walk in the light of creative altruism or we perish in the darkness of destructive selfishness. We have no other country to call our own but this country. All hands must be on deck to build a new Nigeria. Everyone can still restitute. So there should not be outright condemnation of leaders because they can restitute and also be part of the new Nigeria that is to come. And let us take advantage of what our wonderful, glorious youth have done in order to build and repackage ourselves so that our children tomorrow will ask us, what was your role, Daddy, when Nigeria was getting bad? Then we will be able to say we did A, B, C, D. And I use this opportunity to call on Mr. President Muhammadu Buhari to respond to the yearnings and aspirations of the Nigerian youth. The president of this country is not deaf or dumb, so he cannot keep quiet. He must address these youths either as president or as a father. You cannot ignore the youth of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. And I want to pray that this opportunity will take us to the Nigerian of our dream. God bless you. I recommend this book to President Muhammadu Buhari, and that book is Why Nation Fail. By the time the president reads this, I'm sure he will speak to Nigerians. This is a copy I bought and I've personally acknowledged and written and addressed to President Muhammadu Buhari, and I will present this to him in person or through a third party.